using the theory of constraints, TOC,
we are going to identify the bottleneck
and debottleneck the process.
Yes.
So this is the process one.
This is the process two.
This is the process three.
This is the process four.
Let us study this by assembling 15 ball pens. Let's observe the time that we take. Alright, are you ready?
Yes.
Let us start the timer. Start. Can you see what is happening? Can you see what is happening?
Yes, the bottleneck is getting created.
Where is the bottleneck?
I guess me.
Why is it Shruti? Why is Shruti the bottleneck?
Because it's so slowly.
Because?
Because I have maximum WIP.
It's already reached three pieces.
Finish.
Oh, finish.
Okay, how much time did it take?
Oh, maybe the same time.
Yeah, 90 seconds. Okay. We had seen that the bottleneck is the limiting operation. You cannot work faster than the bottleneck. And if the previous operations work faster, it is of no use because the output does not go up and only WIP builds up in between. So we introduce a concept of synchronizing the working of the previous stations to the working of the bottleneck. And of course, you don't have to worry about the after bottleneck operation because it can work only as fast as the bottleneck works. So we will use an indicator like some kind of an alarm. We will just tap the table to indicate that the bottleneck operation has completed one piece. Okay. Are we ready?
Yes, sir.
Let us start. Now that the bottleneck operation Shruti has completed one piece, I tap, which please look here and look there. You will find that they will place one piece down. Now notice that there is no WIP anywhere. Because the previous two operations, Swati and Raj, are working to the synchronized to the bottleneck. When we tap, the previous two stations send the product ahead. If the bottleneck works faster, the tapping will be faster. If the bottleneck works slower, the tapping will be slower. The previous operations will work accordingly. Notice the absence of WIP everywhere. An indication needs to go from the bottleneck operation to the previous ones. Indication from a central planner is no use. Alright, we finish. It will take about the same time because the bottleneck operation was not debottlenecked. It was not improved. So the time will be about the same. But we will not have excess WIP in between. The next step is we need to increase the output from this line. How do we do that?
That can happen only if my bottleneck process produces more.
How can we get Shruti to produce more? Can you work faster?
No, I cannot work faster. I am doing my best here.
What else can we do?
Can we add a resource here?
But that will be added cost.
Okay, so what else can we do?
Maybe you can ask one of them to help me.
Alright. Who could be freed out of the whole group?
I think Owen can help.
Yes, Owen can be freed. Why? Because he had some idle time. His operation was requiring very little time. So we can now have a situation where Shruti does her work and Owen's work, and Owen does his work and Shruti's work.
So let's divide our resources.
So now, two people doing two operations each. Okay? You think we can start?
Wait, yes.
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 Okay, now we can start timing. Okay, are you ready?
Yes.
Okay,
yes,
start please. Now, please look at the WIP. How it is moving. It's disappearing fast. Everybody working as fast as possible, but no WIP happening here. Work in process. WIP happens here for a split second and it disappears. So where is the bottleneck?
No bottleneck.
How can that be?
I am not the bottleneck anymore.
Yeah, actually all of them are the bottleneck. Yeah? Bottleneck is here. Because the rate at which he can produce is the rate at which the rest of them take it forward. Now let's see how much time it took for the entire job to be done, all the 15 pens. Okay, the last one coming up.
And it's almost over.
Yes.
Done.
Okay, stop. How much time?
66.
Yes. 66?
Yes.
66 seconds. That's all. From 90, it has come down to 66. And did we increase the resources?
No.
Just still four of them working. No increase in resources.
Only redistribution of the work.
Exactly. In the first step, we only identified the bottleneck. Nothing else. Then,
in the second step, we saw the synchronized working, where there was no WIP in between, but the output remained same.
And in the third one, we saw that there was no extra cost added, but the work was redistributed.
And the result was increase in output. So we really debottlenecked without increasing cost. There is of course a fourth step. Can you guess what?
Adding resources.
So this is the systematic way in which you debottleneck, and you can get, as this experiment showed, even 50% increase in output. Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you.